There needs to be police reform. This is necessary in order to make policing more efficient, effective, and professional. Serious discussions about reforming police are lost in the noise that police are rotten, policing is systemically racist, or that there should be no police. Police, especially in large urban areas, are more ethnically, racially, and gender diverse than ever before. Police are present in almost every corner of the world. There are reasons for this that have nothing to do with the professor's ranting that police were formed to capture runaway slaves. There are racist cops. They are not all white. People with racist attitudes can be found in virtually every profession. Racist and systemic racism are not the same. Systemic racism is a term too often thrown out to shut down discussions and riddle the accused with guilt while providing the accusers with self-righteousness and immunity from responsibility. Why is a university professor dictating to a student what he should believe about the police? Why is a university professor so closed-minded that she cannot see police as individuals with their own personalities that choose an occupation, policing, for a variety of reasons? Bad cops do not define policing. There are good and bad in all professions. Why have colleges and universities become places of indoctrination? Why are indoctrinators provided public funding? No country can prosper if there is not a certain level of social cohesion. If people are at each other's throats, the ability to solve problems decreases while the propensity towards violence increases. Respectful conversations, consideration, and thoughtfulness are lost in colleges and universities filled with pampered ideologues. The systemic stupidity and indoctrination in universities and colleges needs to stop being funded with taxpayers' money. Too many professors and teachers are privileged elitists freed from real work. They should no longer be afforded this luxury as they poison young minds and hold back generations from learning what it means to think critically, independently, and for themselves.